I don't know about y'all, but that Game of Thrones Season 8 trailer has me hyped. Literally every place I go to, I'm always asking people that look like they might watch the show. I'm like, hey, did you see that new trailer yet? And 9 times out of 10, most people know exactly what I'm talking about, because I'm usually wearing a Game of Thrones t-shirt, but they also go, I can't believe it's finally happening. In this video, I want to discuss some of the more questionable scenes throughout the trailer and pair them with some leaks that have seemingly been confirmed. Now, as we get closer to the season, the dot connecting will become easier and easier. So that means you gotta take certain leaks with a little bit more than a grain of salt. But nonetheless, nothing is 100% confirmed until it airs on our screens in a little over a month. So until then, my advice will remain the same. Consider these more for entertainment purposes, and as always, here's your sign. Before we get started, please slap a like on this video, as the like goal is going to be 2,420. Also, make sure you're subscribed, and then, this is the most important part, make sure you have notifications turned on, so that way you get alerted every single time I drop a Game of Thrones video throughout this long night. Now, the first thing I need to address is something I haven't really talked about in my videos, because I sort of noticed it right away, but then I really didn't pay any more attention after that. Mainly because I've been doing this for 3 seasons now, and I know the type of hype anything surrounding the Night King will cause. Now, in previous seasons, they've released images where people swore that they could see certain things in the Night King's eyes, or that if you look in Jon Snow's eyes, you could see the reflection of the Night King, and this confirms that the Night King has the ability to warg into Jon. It's just a bunch of tinfoily hype train stuff, and it's easy to sort of get caught up in that. Not gonna lie, I probably was responsible for causing some of that. And just as a side note, maybe it is possible for the Night King to warg into Jon. He is of the undead, and for all we know, the Night King controls every person who is died, regardless whether they come back. Maybe he was the one who brought Jon Snow back in the first place, in order for him to get a dragon. See what I mean? But if you'll notice, the Night King's pupils are actually in the shape of the 7-pointed star, the Faith of the Seven. Now, this faith is commonly practiced with the Andals, so a lot of people linked it to the Night King is not a Stark, he's actually an Andal, and this raises even more questions than it answers. My opinion on this whole situation, and you can debate me down in the comment section, is that they're just fucking with us. There's a possibility that the Faith of the Seven is the one true faith, and maybe there's one true god that has all these different aspects in Westeros. It's confusing when you get into the religion aspects, and I think that's going to play a bigger part in the novels, but I feel like what they're insinuating here is the Night King is just another face of the many-faced god. I came up with a theory about a year ago that every single character who is a part of the main cast and who has a role to play in the endgame represents a different deity in A Song of Ice and Fire. For instance, Theon could be the champion of the drowned god, and R'hllor being more powerful, being a more powerful aspect of this one true god, he has two champions, that being Jon Snow and Daenerys. But if my theory is correct, and each different deity who is real in A Song of Ice and Fire has a champion in the endgame, well, that would mean that the Night King is clearly the Great Other's champion. The Night King literally controls the power over death and life. In conclusion, in my opinion, the only reason why the Night King has 7-pointed star contacts in his eyes is because they knew that it would cause hype, and they want to get everyone smoking the tinfoil right before season 8 comes out. So that way everyone's so high, they don't really know what to expect. I mean, just think about it. We've seen the Night King umpteen hundred times, and he's never had these 7-pointed star contacts. I don't think he's going to suddenly change what he looks like in the very final season. But you all let me know what you think, why they did this, down below in the comment section. And you know what? Since we're on the subject of the Night King, let me briefly add this in. Recently, Entertainment Weekly conducted an interview with the actor who plays the Night King, Vladimir Furtick. Now, before he actually became the Night King, he was a stunt person who worked on many different things in Game of Thrones. One of the questions they ask him is, what can we expect to see from the Night King in the final season? And his response was, people will see he has a target he wants to kill, and you will find out who that is. There's a moment also in Hardhome when Jon Snow was on the boat and the Night King looked at him and raised his arms. You know that famous meme that we all got from that, which is, come at me, bro. He mentions that there's a similar and even stronger moment between Jon Snow and the Night King this time around in Game of Thrones Season 8. Now, please feel free to speculate down below what in the hell this could mean, but what gives us a little bit further insight into this is the part that I skipped over at the beginning of the interview. One of the questions they ask is like, what does the Night King want anyway? And Vladimir's answer is, somebody made the Night King. Nobody knows who he was before, Maybe he was a soldier or part of nobility, perhaps. He never wanted to be the Night King. I think he wants revenge. Everybody in this story has two sides, a bad side and a good side. The Night King only has one side, a bad side. So in my opinion, what Vladimir is stating there is that the Night King wants revenge on the person who created him. He also mentioned later on in the interview that he has a target next season and that becomes aware. Now, it could be Jon Snow, but it could also be Bran. Remember, he wants revenge on the person who created him. Bran is imbued with the powers of the Three-Eyed Raven, and the Three-Eyed Raven is responsible for helping the Children of the Forest to create the Night King. All of this destruction and chaos has literally been caused because Bran did not die that night in the cave. Let me rephrase that. Bran died that night in the cave, but the Three-Eyed Raven didn't. Instead, he transferred his essence to Bran. I remember way back in season 6 when Bran first crossed the wall at the very end of the season. Everyone thought this could mean one thing. The Night King, when he goes through the wall, it's all going to be Bran's fault, because he warded off the magic on Blood Raven's cave by touching Bran, so we all thought it'd be a similar effect when Bran crossed through the wall. Another option of who his target could be in Game of Thrones Season 8 could actually be Baby Sam. I've spent several videos talking about that before in the past, so you guys let me know what you think about those three options for his targets down below in the comment section. Remember, those are Jon Snow, Bran, who in my opinion is the most likely choice, and then also Baby Sam. And now on to the leaks. As always, still in air quotations there, what I've gone through is search some of my more recent ones and some of the ones I was sent a while back. I feel like the older leaks that you can compare to the trailer, and if they got a few things right, then that means they may hold a little bit more water. Now the first one is in relation to the scene where we see Jaime yelling at someone in the actual season 8 trailer. Now we could, right after that, see someone fighting with their right hand, which a lot of us think this is going to be Brienne. So the leak goes that Brienne will die fighting in the war, or the battle for Winterfell. The moment in the trailer where Jaime is yelling run, these are actually his last words spoken to Brienne. Right after this, Brienne is overcome by whites and ultimately dies. Thereafter, Jaime gets caught up a little bit in the battle, and when he's finally able to make it over to the last place he saw Brienne, he notices Brienne, and as she turns around, half of her face is missing and her eyes are glowing blue. The two of them square off one final time, and Jaime is ultimately victorious, laying Brienne to rest. Now, the person who sent me this information through the DMs on Twitter, speaking of which, make sure you go follow me at sir_hunt, but this was the same person who predicted the Crypts of Winterfell teaser and confirmed the actual time the trailer was going to be released. They further mentioned that the scene of Jaime explaining why he is there is actually to Sansa. You can see the Stark Bannerman in the background. He arrives to Winterfell before Jon and Daenerys, and Sansa has Jaime arrested immediately. Later, he is then given a chance to speak his case, and this is where he explains to Sansa that he made a promise to fight the dead. Now, the next few leaks that I want to discuss are from the same person, and they kind of just went through the trailer and detailed certain scenes. Now, this one was in context to the scene with Grey Worm and Missandei kissing. They mentioned that Grey Worm dies in the war for Winterfell. He gets one last kiss with Missandei in the trailer and dies shortly after that. His death is the first major character to die of the season, and it's brutal. The whites overpower him and he goes down screaming. Missandei can sense the moment right as it happens. Now there's obviously no context for this in the trailer, and like I said at the very beginning of this video, these are made for entertainment purposes and nothing is 100% confirmed until it airs on your television screens. But one thing I did notice when going back and rewatching this scene is that right to the left of them, you can see these massive wooden objects with huge pieces of dragon glasses sticking out of the large wooden logs. That's pretty badass. Those are going to be barricades for the dead. I'm pretty sure we're going to see a bunch of deads get skewered on those things. And also another thing I noticed from the trailer is if you look at the walls of Winterfell, those little rolling metal things that you can see clearly right here, those were actually pictured in the leaks way, way back in the summer of 2018 when most of the filming for the Battle of Winterfell was going down. And since we're on that subject, there were actually two other leaks that were confirmed to happen through people taking pictures and video of that set in Northern Ireland where they were filming the Battle of Winterfell. The death of Jaime or Brienne and the destruction of Winterfell. Now, originally, when they were filming that scene with Jaime and Brienne, there was a video that went along with it that you could mostly make out the silhouette of Jaime collapsing to the ground. The video was extremely distorted and low quality, but most people felt like it was either Jaime dying or Jaime collapsing for what he had just done. And as far as the destruction of Winterfell, well, there were many different people who posted on the subreddits showing images of Winterfell or the set of Winterfell clearly burning. And not just like a light fire or a controlled burn. The entire set was engulfed in flames. And in my opinion, this means that Winterfell will fall next season. I'm not saying that it won't get rebuilt, but for the the most part, after the Battle of Winterfell, Winterfell will be utterly destroyed and in flames. Now, what actually causes Winterfell to go up in flames and be destroyed is still kind of left up in the air. The obvious choice would be the battle of three massive dragons all duking it out in the sky. That would clearly catch anything surrounding them on fire. But according to the person who sent me the leaks that I mentioned earlier in this video, the reason for Winterfell going up in flames in the end, like after the battle, why it's completely destroyed, is actually because the Golden Company attacks Winterfell while the Night King is attacking. They're able to breach Winterfell, and then they end up taking Sansa hostage. The leaker claims that there are two different scenes in the trailer that confirm this happening if you give a little bit more context to them. The first one is when Cersei's on that balcony with Qyburn, and whatever she says to Qyburn makes him react horribly. Apparently, that scene actually begins with Qyburn walking up to Cersei while Cersei's watching the arrival of the Golden Company. Cersei begins informing him of her plan to load the Golden Company and Euron's ships up with wildfire and have them go and attack Winterfell directly while Jon and Daenerys are least expecting it. She claims that they will be able to take out the Starks, the Targaryens, and the threat of the undead all at once. Qyburn warns her that this may not be the best move, but Cersei says, "I will not need an army if I have no enemies to face." And the other scene that sort of somewhat confirms this from the trailer is when the Golden Company can be shown and we see Harry Strickland from the back. If you'll notice down in the left-hand corner, there's actually barrels being rolled into position. Those barrels, according to this leaker, actually contain wildfire and are going to be used at Winterfell. Now you're probably like, okay, Sir Hunts, you're mentioning a bunch of information from this person and you're not really mentioning the confirmed part. Well, we do know from the leaks from the Battle of Winterfell that the Greyjoys will show up during the Battle of Winterfell. And not just any Greyjoys, we do know that Theon went down to King's Landing to go and attempt to rescue Yara, but the Greyjoys that are present here dead in these images have the same sigil as some of Euron's men. Now, another thing that's interesting is that there were a few corpses that were apart, and obviously these are all fake, they're props used for the filming of this battle at Winterfell, but some of them were unidentified. No one really knew who they were. Now we know these are confirmed to be the Golden Company. And one more scene that is somewhat confirmed by this person, giving more context rather, before we get out of here, is actually the scene of Cersei crying. According to this person, this is actually when Cersei realizes that Jaime has betrayed her for the last time. When Cersei captures Sansa and holds her hostage, her plan is to have Jon Snow come down to King's Landing and sort of do a trade-off. She wants to talk with Jon Snow and have him bend the knee and swear allegiance to her as opposed to Cersei. He mentions that something happens in season 8 that makes Cersei have the upper hand in the battle, and Jon is sort of forced to do this, mainly because he wants to make sure Sansa is safely returned home. Jon, of course, refuses to bend the knee and is taken to a cell. After he arrives in his cell, Jaime reveals himself to be one of the guards and tells Jon, "Don't drink the water, he's going to be back to help them escape." Now, other than these images of Jon Snow meeting with Cersei, we don't really have any proof that any of this stuff goes down. One thing that is interesting is that there are a bunch of people over on Reddit that do believe there's a possibility that Sansa will be captured, and the reason why Jon Snow meets with Cersei is to turn himself in as a hostage. It does appear as though this person walking beside him is not from his camp, and this makes most people think that he's being taken somewhere against his will. And you know what? We're doing pretty well on time again for this video, so I'm going to mention one more leak, although it is in no way confirmed, but I do think it's extremely interesting. This was the first time I was ever sent any information from this person, and I feel like this is someone who just watched the trailer a billion times and became extremely astute. If you'll notice, when we see the Golden Company leader, Harry Strickland, from the back, it's very clear that he's wielding some sort of sword that will likely prove to be Valyrian steel. This person states that that sword is Blackfyre, and just for a brief history lesson, Blackfyre is an ancient Valyrian steel sword of House Targaryen. It was actually wielded by Aegon the Conqueror when he first united the Seven Kingdoms. The sword was passed down for a little while in House Targaryen, and in 182 AC, when King Aegon the Unworthy Targaryen chose to bestow Blackfyre on his bastard son Daemon Waters instead of his legitimate future son Daeron II Targaryen. Now, Aegon the Unworthy was a bit of a bastard, and the fact that he gave his bastard son the one sword that most people felt the only true Targaryen heirs are to wield caused a bunch of chaos and caused what's known as the Blackfyre Rebellion. Long story short, the last time Blackfyre was actually seen was when Bittersteel took it over to Essos and founded the Golden Company. Then jumping into this leak here, the person states that you can see the Golden Company leader Harry Strickland in the trailer with Blackfyre. During the siege of Winterfell, while they're, you know, following Cersei's orders to go and kidnap Sansa, some of the men are awestruck by the sight of the dragons. Harry, who's the leader of the Golden Company, is included. It reminds him of their true loyalty, that they are descended from Targaryens and the blood of the dragons. They start a mutiny, and this forces Euron to flee back to King's Landing empty-handed. Now, I don't know how credible that leak is, but one thing I will say that's interesting is that in the TV show way in the earlier seasons, Jorah actually mentions to Daenerys that he worked for the Golden Company before being employed by her brother, Viserys. I don't know if it's just the dragons that make the Golden Company decide to go and join Daenerys' army, but I think Jorah, maybe talking to Harry Strickland, could also do a bit of the convincing. But either way, you all let me know what you think about that down below in the comments section. And with that being said, I want to thank you all so much for watching. If you could please slap a like on this video, as the like goal is going to be 2,420. Also, make sure you're subscribed. And then, this is the most important part, make sure you have notifications turned on so that way you get alerted every single time I drop a Game of Thrones video throughout this long night. A super special thank you to every single person who watched this video, and a special thank you to every single member of my Patreon family over on patreon.com/SirHuntsReviews. I want to thank you all again so much for watching. My name's Mark, and this has been Sir Hunts Reviews.